Hello, learners, and welcome to today's learning session. It's another moment that we continue learning. It has been said that learning never stops because the universe keeps teaching. In our today's lesson, we are going to learn how to determine the net worth of a business. Net worth of a business. In our previous sessions, we defined assets, liabilities, and capital. And we said, just to do a small recap, that assets are items of value owned by a business. Then we defined liabilities. We said that liabilities represents what the business owes others. What the business owes others. Then we defined capital as the owner's claim in the business. We learned that assets are items of value owned by a business. We gave examples, like before examples, we classified these assets into two: fixed assets and current assets. We say that fixed assets are assets that are permanent. These are assets that are expected to remain in the business for a long period of time, which is more than 12 months. We gave examples: motor vehicles, buildings, land, furniture, motor vehicles, and so on. These are items of value which the business buys, and the purpose is not for resale, but to be used in the business to generate revenue. Then there is the current assets. We say that current assets are assets that are short-term in nature. They are also referred to as short-term assets. These assets are maintained in the business for a short period of time, that is usually less than 12 months. Examples: stock, debtors, cash at bank, cash in hand, and so on. That is what we learned about assets. Then we also say liabilities can also be categorized into two: long-term liabilities and short-term liabilities. We said that long-term liabilities are liabilities that are expected to be repaid after a long period of time, usually more than 12 months. And these are long-term loans. 2-year bank loan, that's an example. Then the short-term liabilities. Short-term liabilities are the liabilities that are expected to be repaid within a shorter period of time, usually within 12 months. Example: creditors, 6-month bank loan, overdrafts, and such. So those are liabilities. We went further and defined capital to be the owner's claim in the business. And this owner's claim in the business includes the capital, that is the money. We said maybe money, the cash money, or items of value that the owner injects in the business. I gave an example of a motor vehicle. If the owner has a motor vehicle, he can bring that motor vehicle into the business. So that will form part of capital. So that is what we discussed in our previous sessions. We went further again to learn more about the bookkeeping equation. We learned about the bookkeeping equation. Bookkeeping equation. And we say that the bookkeeping equation may also be referred to as the balance sheet. Balance sheet equation or the accounting equation. These words are used interchangeably, the same thing. And we gave the bookkeeping equation. We say that assets equal liabilities plus capital. This is the bookkeeping equation. Assets equal liabilities plus capital. Then we went further to learn how to prepare a simple balance sheet. In our last lesson, we saw how to prepare a simple balance sheet, and we defined a balance sheet as a statement that shows the financial position of a business at a particular date, okay, as far as the assets, liabilities, and capital are concerned. So a balance sheet, we said, is a statement that shows the financial balance sheet. We said is a statement that indicates the financial, is a statement that shows the financial position of a business at a particular time. And we say that within the balance sheet, you'll have the assets. Balance sheet will have assets on one side and liabilities and capital on the other side. Balance sheet will have, we record assets on one side and capital and liabilities on the other side. So we have a list of capital items, we have a list of liability items, and we'll have assets. And you can see, learners, that the balance sheet is prepared on the basis of the accounting equation. From this equation, you can see assets appear on one side, liabilities and capital appear on the other side. So when you have items in this balance sheet, the two sides must agree. When you get the totals, these two sides must be the same, because assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. That is, in summary, what we have so far learned under this topic. Now, in our today's lesson, I want us to learn how to determine the net worth of a business. Worth refers to value, the net value of a business. Net worth of a business. Now, candidates, what's the meaning of net worth? Net worth. What's the meaning of this word? Net worth. Now, net worth of a business is made up of the funds of the proprietor. The funds of the proprietor plus the profit minus the drawings. That would give us the net worth of a business. Net worth of a business. In other words, the net worth of a business is the excess of assets over liabilities. Is excess of assets over liabilities. It's the excess of assets over liabilities. Where assets are more than liabilities. That's what we mean by excess of assets over liabilities. Where assets are more than the liabilities, then there is net worth. But in the case where the liabilities are more than the assets, then we have what we call deficiency. We have what we call deficiency. So just to note down, we can say the net worth. The net worth of a business is made up of funds used to start business. Funds used to start business plus any additional capital plus profit minus drawings. In other words, it is the excess of assets over liabilities. The excess of assets over liabilities. Now, I want you to imagine, just to help you understand what I'm talking about here, I want you to imagine that you have started a business of, say, running a shop. You are started a business on. Imagine that you've started a business. This is an illustration. Imagine that you have started a business, say a shop, and started a business. Business on January 1st of January 2019 you started a business, and you had cash at the bank. Cash at the bank amounting to shillings 150,000. You've started a business. Think of a shop that is buying and selling commodities, food items, and such like. Bread, milk, you sell bread, you sell milk, you sell other items like stationery and so on. So on this day you had 150,000 shillings, and that's the only money you had. You rented a shop, and because you didn't have any money, for you to run a shop, you need to have furniture, you need to have a table, you need to have, you have chairs, okay? So other than the 150,000 shillings, you took your own furniture from your house, furniture amounting to 200,000 shillings. And for you to run a shop effectively, learners, you may need to transport goods. When you go to the market to buy goods, you need to transport goods. And because you don't have money to buy a van, delivery van, or a motor vehicle, you use your own motor vehicle. So you'll have motor vehicle. You did not buy it, but you took your own motor vehicle, which is valued at 2 million. 2 million. 2 million shillings. This is on the first day. You've gone to the, you've rented a shop, you've decided to start business, you have cash at the bank, you have, that's the only thing you have, but you have other assets. So these are assets. And the total assets, let's get the total. The total assets, 150 plus 200 plus 2 million, this will be equal to 2,350,000. Candidates, this is what we call capital. So capital, as we defined earlier, is the cash or property that a proprietor uses to start a business. So it's important to note, capital is not restricted to cash. It's not restricted to cash only. It can be cash or property that is used in starting a business. If you are to start a business on that date, you can see you have cash at bank, furniture, motor vehicles, total 2,350,000. That is before you start operations. The capital is 2,350,000. Very important point. Capital constitutes the money or the property that a proprietor uses to start business. To start business. So the net worth, the net worth of this business at the start, okay, at the start, the net worth, we've defined here net worth as the excess of assets over liabilities. Net worth is the excess of assets over liabilities. If you are to determine the net worth of this business before operations on day one, then the net worth we said is the excess of assets over liabilities. In other words, it's assets minus liabilities. So we've seen the total assets here. We have shillings, 2,350,000, and there are no liabilities. So the total, the net worth will be equal to 2,350,000 shillings. This is the net worth of this business on day 1. 1, the first day before operations. This is the net worth. And something I need you to also note, learners, is that when you start a business and you inject cash in the business, you inject furniture, motor vehicle, these assets are no longer your assets. These are assets that belong to the business. There has to be a distinction between, a distinction has to be made between the business and the owner. The business and the owner. When you bring these assets to the business, then these are deemed to be the assets of the business until at a point when maybe you wind up the business or you stop operations. When you stop operations and you pay all the liabilities, whatever remains now reverts back to you. So this cash, for example, when you take your own money to start a business, then in most cases, proprietors would take this money to the business bank account, to the business bank account. The money will be transferred from the personal account to the business bank account because there is a difference between the one who is running the business and the business. And that's why you see some businesses have names, okay? Business have names. That's the names are to distinguish the owners and the businesses. So net worth on the first day of operations is equal to the assets minus liabilities. When you are starting business, before you start operations, there are no liabilities. So the net worth will be assets minus liabilities, in this case, 2,350,000. So calculating net worth of a business is simple. So learners, this is on day one. I now want you to imagine again, I want you to imagine on January 2, the second day, January 2nd, 2019, the proprietor bought goods on credit amounting to 60,000 shillings. Amounting to 60,000 shillings. Just imagine you are the one who has started a business and you have all these assets, that is your capital on day one. Then on the second day, you go to the market and you buy goods. The purpose for buying goods is so that you can resell, because that is business. Business means buying and selling of goods or services. On the second day, you go to the market, you buy goods amounting to 60,000 shillings so that you can resell the goods and make profit. Now, on this day, learners, we can see that the net worth changes, because when you buy goods on credit, when you buy goods on credit, then you see on this day, let's look at the assets, because remember, you have assets, net worth. You want to calculate the net worth on the second day. We have assets and liabilities. So we can have a list of assets. What assets do we have on the second day? You still have the cash of 150,000 shillings. Furniture is still in place. Furniture, 200,000 shillings. The motor vehicle, you have it. Motor vehicle, 2 million. 2 million shillings. Then on the second day, you buy goods. When you buy goods, then you have stock. you have added an asset there, stock, of 60,000. So the total assets will be what you had at start. Then there is an additional asset, current asset of 60,000. So 60,000 plus 2,350,000 is equal to 2,410,000. These are assets. Okay, these are assets. Then we have a liability here. Liabilities. You bought goods on credit. You increased your stock by 60,000, but you created a liability because these goods were not paid for. When you buy goods and you don't pay, then you owe the supplier. This supplier is what we call creditor. So you have to pay the creditor at some point, 60,000. Maybe this creditor has given you a period, what we call credit period. He's told you that you pay these 60,000 after, say, 1 month or 2 months. So you have a creditor. This is a liability. So you can see the net worth on the second day. Net worth will be equal to assets minus liabilities. And the assets you have seen is 2,410,000 minus the 60,000. So the net worth will still be the 2,350,000 net worth. Learners, I want you to notice that the net worth has not changed. The net worthness of the business still remains the same. And why is it that the net worth has not changed? This is the reason. The net worth has not changed because you see this net worth is the same as this net worth is because this transaction of buying goods on credit had an effect of increasing the stock by 60 and introducing a liability of 60,000. So 60,000, the assets has gone up by 60,000. And creditors have also gone up by 60,000. So these assets have gone up by 60,000. Then we have deducted the 60,000 again. So that means there is no increase in the net worth. The assets have gone up by 60,000. That is from 2,350,000 to 2,410,000. But assets have gone up by the same amount, meaning the net worth remains the same. The net worth in that case remains the same. I want you again to use your imagination. I want you to imagine this transaction. On January 30th, 2019, sold all the goods, and received, let me say, check payment of 100,000 shillings. 100,000 shillings. That is on the second transaction, happened on January 30th. All these goods that were bought on 2nd of January, all the goods have been sold, and the business has received a check of 100,000 shillings. 100,000 shillings. So what will be the net worth after 30th of January 2019? So here, let's see the effect. What is the effect of this transaction on capital? On capital. So allow me to rub this. That. So these are the assets that were in place before the transaction on January 30th. These were the assets. And all the goods have been sold, meaning that there is no longer this item of stock. There are no stocks. So we remove the stocks. We remove the stocks. The stocks have been sold. So the effect is that the stocks go down. All the items of stock will go down. We reduce by 60,000. So there is no stock after 30th of January. But there is another item that has been introduced here. This is a bank. The goods were sold and the payment were made by check. All checks are processed through the bank. So the money goes to the bank and the amount is 100,000 shillings. 100,000 shillings. So these are the new assets after 30th of January. These are the new assets. So we have 150 plus 200. This is 350 plus 2 million. This is 350 plus 100. You have 2,450,000. So 2,450,000. These are the total assets on that date. Then we still have this liability. Liabilities. There is still this liability. The goods that were bought on credit have not been paid. So we still have this creditor. The amount, 60,000. So the net worth is equal to the assets minus liabilities. The assets, we have 2,450,000. Thousand minus 60,000. So this is 2,450,000 minus 60. I'm getting here 2,350,000. 2,390,000. 2,390,000 is the new net worth. Assets minus liability. Assets minus liabilities. You see now there is an increase in the net worth. And why is there an increase, learners? It's because the goods that were bought at 60,000 shillings were sold at 100,000 shillings. That means the owner made profit. The owner made some profit. Owner made some profit. And this takes me back to our definition here. Net worth of a business is made up of funds or property used to start business, plus any additional capital, plus profit. profit, very important. Plus profit minus drawings. Minus drawings. If the owner takes money or goods for personal use, then that reduces the net worth. If you are running a business and you take part of the money for the business, or you draw some goods from the business for personal use, then that reduces the net worth. Reduces the net worth. So in a nutshell, candidates, we can say, we can reduce this, we can say net worth is equal to capital, whether it's a capital you are using when you are starting or additional capital, because you can also introduce capital when the business is still ongoing. So we have capital at start, then we add the profit, then deduct the drawings. That will give you the net worth of a business. And we have demonstrated in these examples how profit increases the net worth. If there is another transaction where the owner took away some goods for personal use, then we reduce that by the amount. Looking at the second definition, we see that net worth is the excess of assets over liabilities. So net worth, again, can be calculated by simply deducting liabilities from assets. Liabilities from assets, what we have done here. Net worth is deducting liabilities from assets. So in other words, from this formula, we can just also say net worth is equal to the capital, which is equal to assets minus liabilities. Net worth, this net simply means you are determining or calculating the net assets. So net worth, we can also say net worth is equal to assets minus liabilities, assets minus liabilities, which is equal to the net assets. Net worth is simply the net assets. How do you calculate net assets? Net assets is determined by deducting liabilities from assets. You get the total liabilities, deduct from the total assets, you get the net assets. That's the meaning of net worth. It is the total net assets of a business. It represents the owner's final claim on the assets of the business. You can also write it net worth represents the owner's can be one owner or many owner's final claim on the assets of the business after outsiders outsiders claims have been paid. Net worth represents the owner's final claims on the assets of the business after outsiders' claims have been paid. So these are outsiders' liabilities. Remember, we define liabilities as the outsiders' claim over the assets of the business. Over the assets of the business. We've given an example here. This creditor has a claim over the assets of a business because the creditor has not been paid. He has a claim over the assets of the business. If the business is to close on this debt, then this creditor will step forward and claim the 60,000. So this 60,000 cannot be part of the net worthness of a business because it belongs to someone from outside. So the net worth of a business, in other words, is just the owner's equity. Owner's equity. Owner's equity. And we have seen at the start of the business, the owner's equity at the start of this business is simply the cash that he had at the start of the business or any other property that was introduced when beginning the business. So at this point, the net worth of a business is simply equal to the total assets of the business or the capital because there are no liabilities. But as the business continues to operate and make profit, making losses, sometimes the owner withdrawing business from the mean cash or goods from the business, then the formula changes. We'll have the net worth being equal to the capital at start plus any capital introduced during the course of the business plus profit made minus drawings. So these are ways in which the net worthness of a business can be determined. So candidates, this is what we can say about the net worth of a business. And just to extend it a bit, it's possible also to have the net worth of an individual, what we call personal net worth. Here is we are discussing the net worthness of a business, but individuals also have net worth. As a student, you can also determine your net worth. You put down the assets that you have. Maybe you have a phone, you have clothes. Some students have bicycles, others have motorbikes. All those are assets, okay? Assets which are in your name, okay? So you can get the total. Then if you have any liabilities, maybe you went to the canteen, you did not pay. That is a creditor. Or you have taken some loan, mobile loan, okay? Or say 1,000 shillings. So you need to get all those liabilities deduct from the assets that will constitute your personal net worth. Learners, that marks the end of our today's learning session. I will see you in our next lesson.